What's up, Diaries? Darguin here. Welcome back to another Leper Survival video. Now, let me explain myself. I haven't done a video in a straight week. I apologize for that. It's mainly because of all the classes, work, and just pure laziness of just doing my own thing and just being really lazy, basically. But I decided to make a video today, getting some of my energy back. And overall, I'm going to be making a tips and tricks video because I haven't done this in a few months, and I feel like you guys are gonna really enjoy and take me about the Juggernaut one on the dock map. So yeah, we're gonna be getting into that later on, and yeah, that's basically it. Let's do this. Number one, when you're the hunter or the crawler, you can actually climb these square ladders on certain maps, like the construction map, the canyon map, and stuff like that. Now, the way you do it is you just have to go up to them and just get in the middle of it and just keep on going forward until you eventually start climbing upwards. Number two, when there is a Molotov in the air or just wherever it is, shoot over it or underneath the Molotov fire area, because if you just shoot the flames, it will actually just block all bullets. But if you shoot underneath the flames or on top of the flames or over the flames, as you could say, then it will actually go on the other side and you can actually hit all the other zombies without taking much damage depending how far of a distance you are. Number three, defenders will actually block a riot's rush attack at you. All you have to do is just stand in front of your defender and they will actually block a riot's rush attack at you. So there's a pretty easy but kind of hard trick to pull off. Number four, never spend too much time doing other things like shooting zombies, getting loot, and basically finding areas to be at. And always take a look at your surroundings because you never know if there's a Tingler aiming at you or a hunter about to strike on you or anything else about to happen to you apart from you, like, you know, getting damaged and all. Because you always want to make sure that you're not going to get damaged or not going to die at any millisecond, and you always want to make sure you've got the advantage. Number five, whenever you're on a building, always shove off bloaters so you can't actually get damaged from their explosion attacks, and also every other zombie so you don't want to, like, spend much ammo and time on them. Number six, whenever you're either above or below a chiller's ice ability, it will not actually affect you at all, as long as you're either above the chiller or below the chiller. Number seven, whenever a banshee is on her stage to attack mode, do a spin and just keep moving around, basically around them, to confuse them and to not give them any advantages of basically hitting you, and you can also be able to laser them while you're doing that. Number 8, whenever you're on a high building, never stand still for too long. You never know if there's a riot or Tingler aiming at you and they're going to push you off or pull you off. Always stay on the move, basically just move around and make it harder for all the other zombies to have a clear shot on you. If you're ever the riot or the Tingler, observe your surroundings first. You never know if you can actually push the survivors into a more deadlier position than they were before. Number 10, if you're ever a survivor and you're basically like the last one or just like the few last ones, always kill the Tanglers and the Hunters first because they will always screw your day over in a millisecond. Number 11, if you're ever on the dock map and you're the Juggernaut and they're on the survivors on top of the first building with like the ladder and on the second floor, if you're on the first floor, put a box really close to the ladders, basically touching the ladders, basically like all two corners are actually touching the ladder, basically, and jump very, very carefully, or just very precisely, because if you jump and then move, you have a higher chance of actually grabbing onto the ledge and climbing onto the second floor. I've recently learned this, and it is crazy, basically. Now, it's pretty difficult to pull off, but as long as you put the box really close to the ladder, basically in front of the ladder, and you jump and then move, then it's actually a really easy tactic and you should get it first try all the time. What's up, Diaries? Darguin here, and you made it to the end of the video. Now, I apologize that I haven't uploaded for a week. I'm really sorry about that. But videos are starting to come up soon, and yeah, make sure to join the Left 4 Survival community. Please like to us Left 4 Survival game, and yeah, I'll see you all in 5 years.